So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Harvard Crimson and the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Bulldogs should be able to run away with this one, Dick Vitale.
Hey, what are the keys for them doing so? The keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Secondly, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. And finally, make sure you eat up the boards.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He'll regroup the offense. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from left of the circle. Way off target. Up and in.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Jumps in. Contact causes the shot to come off. Turns it over. He pulls the trigger. He's money with the shot. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
From the baseline. Gets it to go. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Down he goes, and no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Look at that spacing.
Inside, takes the pass in the paint. Takes the jumper, and come up short. Number 22 is feeling great right now.
I love seeing players play with emotion and passion. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Puts up the J, off the mark. He keeps the dribble as they reset. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gotta eliminate those turnovers. High post screen. Gonna use it. There's the trap.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. The circle, they work it around the perimeter.
I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. The small forward with the ball. He launches the bomb. Off the rim and no good. Inside, the center gets the ball and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the outside, number 42 takes the pass. Will take the shot.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
He goes for three. It sticks. They'll work it around the arc. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Number 22 gets the pass. That's a great response by this crowd.
What a response. What enthusiasm.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing the ball, ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Stolen away. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. Number 20 takes the feed and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. Watch out, 5-second call approaching.
In and out. Kick it back outside. He shoots from the top of the key.
He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
He fakes the shot. Way out on top, controlling the ball. Too much contact there and knocked him off balance a little. Trying to pack it inside. With a little baby hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Number 33 takes it away. Both teams looking to get things going here. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us here.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
Fed the low block.
Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
The skip pass is picked off. Number 42 with the foul. First team foul. The Crimsons are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. He gets it to go. Both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Big time screen set on the defender that time. Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player, and he made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Attempts the trifecta, way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two.
I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
Entry pass in the paint.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Working around the perimeter.
Cup it inside.
He puts up the three ball. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. in the paint. Trying to draw some contact. That kid's making him think about every shot, Dick.
And he's doing it without fouling, which is the key.
This young man means so much to this team, and the fans just love it.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
He makes a nice shot fake. He looks at the hoop, and the ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Gave it up.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
They're off into transition.
High step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Barishnikov in shorts, little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. From three-point territory, great shot.
Are you kidding me? Show me how he did that.
On the inside, he beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
For two, perfectly executed. He got it off in time. He clangs the three-point attempt. At halftime, the Bulldogs are ahead by five. We've had a very tight contest tonight, Dick. What's your highlight of the half?
This one's big for me, Brad. The long trifecta. Shots like this can sometimes get a team going in a hurry.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Harvard has a lot more turnovers than I'm used to seeing them have in a first half, Dick.
I must admit it, I'm still trying to figure out their game plan. Do they think they can win without any offensive possessions? It would take a miracle for that to happen. Great anticipation defensively.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I can hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. From three-point land. Good. With a jump hook, and he missed. The power forward handles the pass. Goes up for two. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their voice is beginning to fade.
Controlling the ball. They work the perimeter. The shooting guard handles the feed.
Nice fake.
On the dribble, gives it up. And he'll kick it back outside. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He tries a jump hook. Can't get the shot to drop.
Hey,
gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He up fakes. Good fake. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around, fadeaway. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. The small forward receives the ball. Shoots it. Rims out. Gave it up.
Up and inside. Set that screen away.
Sinks it.
Oh, my goodness. That was unbelievable, baby.
Working it around the perimeter.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane. Let's go to the videotape for that one.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
He used the screen to create the space for the score on the inside.
On the dribble, gives it up. Time to pick up the defense here now.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
On the outside, he shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. It's stolen.
Line of ball, pressure, help side, it's all there.
Picks off the pass for two. Harvard are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense.
Gave it up. The center receives the pass. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick T.O., baby. A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats. Hey, this crowd will be ecstatic if they can get a basket.
Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
They come with a double team to stop it. He strips him clean. On the dribble, gives it up. For the deuce. Doesn't go.
Nice hop.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Fakes it. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Picked off. Gave it up. Working around the perimeter.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
Kicks it out. He pump fakes. He looks for three. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The fake. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
On the dribble, gives it up. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
For the bucket. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
The turn of fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, he's got every move in the book. What an offensive player. That fadeaway's impossible to block.
Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
The lay-in. Pushes it. Looking for a good shot. Robs him of the ball. Fast break possibility coming. Goes up for two. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
That's a good job drawing the foul off the pro hop, Brad.
Well, the defender really didn't have a choice. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. The Bulldogs will step to the line for the first time. Gets the first. Gets the second. 6 points separating these two squads.
This is no time to get complacent, Brad.
He quickly brings it up court. Takes the pass in the paint. Pass down low. There's a drop step and, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stopped with a foul. He goes to the line for the first time. Well, the arc looked good.
It's a two-possession game if they can score here.
floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Thanks, Aaron. The lead is six.
Hey, a tray here in this place will go absolutely bananas, Brad. I can feel it.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Here's a nice face-up down in the low block. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The ball goes out of bounds. I think it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
Shot clock is dead. There's the turnover situation for the half-dick.
I'll tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
No rebounding that. He hits his second.
A Buccaneer is crucial.
It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
He shoots from right of the circle.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. With the free one. He sinks it. Second shot is good. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
He fires from long range. Rims out. Now they work it around the perimeter. Intercepted. Launches it. And he misses the shot. Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you've got to win it. Keep on going to get to that final Monday night in April.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
Gonzaga played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first round opponent.
Mr. Nesla, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron.